Thank you for the very warm welcome, and I'm delighted to be here. I was asked to do this gig a few months ago, and they said, what we'd like you to do is choose an artwork. And I come to the Whitworth a lot, and have done for most of my life, also with my son. And I was sent a catalogue of 10,000 artworks, which was quite overwhelming, because a lot of them have a really powerful meaning for me. So I came to the Whitworth a few times and got really confused. And I went to have a coffee, and just beside the restaurant was the Jacob Epstein. And I love Jacob Epstein, I don't know why I didn't think of that in the first place, really. So I'm doing a program of music that is about creation. It's about adding and supporting older music and also brand new music and creating something that's individual. So first I'm playing a piece by Bach. It's the final two movements of Bach First Cello Suite. It was written about 1720. There was a bit of a scandal a few years ago when an Australian musicologist suggested that it was actually written by his wife, and people went mental because they didn't think a woman could actually write a piece of music that good, which was quite entertaining. So it's in two movements, and the first one is a minuet, which is quite a stately kind of thing in 3-4. It's all based on actual baroque dances. And the second one is Gigue, which basically sounds like a drinking song. Not that I would know, obviously. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to play the pieces as they're written and then do some improvisation around them. Bach was a consummate improviser, and improvisation was the norm at that time. Everybody improvised. And that's kind of died out, and I'm trying to bring it back because it's fun. Also terrifying, and I might really mess up, so if I do, it'd be nice to be. Okay, so I will start with the last two movements of the Bach Cello Suite in G, but it's not actually in G because I read it at the fifth and my bass is tuned to seven strings, so it's actually in E for the musos who will shout at me. Okay, enjoy, thanks.
Thank you. but it is basically a rock.
Responsible for what you're about to hear. The piece is called Constellation 2, and it's a form of notation called the graphic score, which looks like this. This is the image of it. The way this is made, this is a piece of manuscript paper overprinted with the pattern of the constellations as they should be tonight, if I've got it right. So I was thinking that in theory, when it goes dark, we should be able to look out the window and see the same pattern as the piece. Of course, I forgot that Manchester's not famed for its clear skies, its rain-free climate. So the interpretation of the piece is quite free. There's quite a lot of the choices and decisions left of the performer. There's also a couple of spaces where the performer can put in things from other parts of the programme. So you might hear a tiny bit of the bark from early on what's been completed. So thank you, Heather. Thank you.